Hello and welcome to Eco Living 42. In this series of videos, I'd like to cover all issues that relate to eco living, whether they be clean drinking water, renewable power sources, or looking at devices that perhaps make our lives easy in everyday living in terms of eco living. We want to look at the latest news and review any items which may impact our world in terms of eco living. If those of you who follow my YouTube channel, my personal YouTube channel, will know that I build several little devices which are solar powered. So we'll be covering a few of those. Like this one here, it's a little simple Pelican box. I bought some cheap solar cells off Amazon and put them together. And it's a very simple device that powers a radio. Stepping up from that, I put together a self-contained box that you can use for backpacking. This powers my little QRP amateur radio. It's got a built-in solar charger, battery, and all the bits are self-contained with a solar panel on the top here, which can be removed and put out in the sun if you're sitting in the shade. We'll also look at some interesting issues that might provoke a little bit of thought. The Amazon Kindle is a wonderful device, which I must say I really enjoy using, but is it eco-friendly? Yes, it provides books electronically, but is it any better than just pulling out the old-fashioned book and reading a book? Let's go into a little more detail on some of the technologies which might affect you if you plan to put solar power in your house. For instance, if you're going to solar power your house, have you stopped to think about what type of solar panel you're going to use? You get polycrystalline solar panels, you get monocrystalline panels, you get amorphous panels, and you get SiGs or GSE panels. And many manufacturers of these panels lay certain claims about how well they'll work under certain light conditions. And we're going to do a little review to see whether those claims are true or not. Wind power. It's something that I thought is absolutely brilliant. It's a great way of producing a renewable energy, but it has its issues. So let's just go take a quick look at that. So here we have the wind turbine down on the shore of Lake Erie at the Great Lakes Science Center in Cleveland, Ohio. And as you can see, it's going at a fairly nice pace today. It's about 150 feet tall and generates about 225 kilowatts of power. But these, although they do produce a rather valuable source of renewable energy, they also have their issues. When they're placed near farms or places of residence, the shadow cast by the blades can actually cause people to get into a state of depression when it's just flashing across their houses, and the noise that it can generate. So those are the kinds of issues that we'll be looking at as we take a closer look at these wind turbines. So as you can see, that wind generator down on the Lake Erie shore is a large, majestic machine, but perhaps they have their issues, and we'll take a closer look at those in future episodes. But for next week, I'm going to bring you some interesting news. The piece of news I'm going to bring next week is a device which a group of university students put together. It's a bicycle which acts as water storage and filters the water while the bike is actually being ridden. Very interesting. So that will be the first bit of news that I bring to you in episode one. Then we'll go cover off the water project, basically turning rainwater from a roof into drinking water. And then we'll do a little bit of a review of devices that can perhaps be used to purify your drinking water. We'll have a closer look at this, what is called the SteriPen. It's a device that can be used if there's a problem with your water supply, or if you go away camping or traveling and you weren't worried about the water, you simply take it, insert it into a bottle of drinking water, turn it on, and the UV light purifies your water. How well does it work? How effective is it? We'll take a closer look at that and how it works. So thank you very much for reviewing this kind of intro episode into EcoLiving 42. I hope you'll follow us. Do subscribe to the new channel on YouTube. It's EcoLiving 42, or one word. There's obviously also the website where you can go and look at the episodes. That's ecoliving42.com. I'll also be telling you about a ride that I'll be participating in next year. It's the Ride Across America. It's 3,000 miles in 7 days. I'll be doing it with a group of, there'll be four of us doing it, and we'll be raising funds for clean drinking water for those in need. So anyway, thank you very much. I hope you enjoy it. We'll enjoy this series. And I say, do follow us if you're interested in topics which relate to eco drinking water. Do post comments. If you find anything newsworthy, drop us a line and perhaps we will air it on the series. Thank you very much.